Alan, you've come to the right place.
What can I get?
A few drinks, a few laughs, and a contest. What could be better? Ha! We'll see about that. This is a special brew. Very strong stuff. Let's get started.
Hungry, tired, or just plain thirsty?
I'll start round one. Down the hatch. Your turn. One down, my friend. One down. All right. And another one for me. And how about you? So says you. I think I've hit my limit on these things. Tell you what, one more and you win the contest. Wow. You've really done it. The staff is yours. You know, you're a fun person to drink with. I know this great little place where the wine flows like water. We should head there. Hey, you don't look so good.
Wake up. That's right. It's time to wake up, you drunken blasphemer. Of course, you don't remember getting here. I'm guessing you also don't remember coming in here and blathering incoherently about marriage or a goat. Which means you don't remember losing your temper and throwing trash all over the temple. Dibella teaches love and compassion, but that doesn't mean we're just going to tell you what you want to know and let you walk away from this. Pick up your mess, then apologize. And if we think you're sincere, we'll consider lending you aid.
I'm still here.
I suppose that'll do. Dibella teaches us forgiveness, after all. Even for a drunk like you. You were ranting when you got here, but most of it was slurred. You did say something about Rorikstead. Maybe you should take a look there.
Let's get going. Stop. What is it? Thank you.
under control. There are no Forsworn here.
Did you see that, Lantern? A Forsworn agent. Here in the city.
We'll handle things from here.
A woman attacked right on the streets. Are you alright? Did you see what happened? I'm so sorry. I hope the aid give you more peace in the future.
Oh, I think you dropped this. Some kind of note. It's important.
No. I was just getting some fresh air. Had one too many pints of mead at the Silver Blood Inn. My note? No, that's yours. Must have fallen out of your pocket. I'd better get going.
By the gods, that man nearly killed me. You saved my life. Thank you. Here. I was gonna bring this to my sister, but I think you should have it. No. I don't have any idea. I was just shopping for a pendant for my sister back in the Imperial City. I've heard of them. Something about the men who live in the hills and attack caravans. I'm sorry. I don't know anymore. I'm just visiting here from Cyrodiil. Until next time.
Let's get going. We've stopped. What is it?
All right, hand over your valuables, or I'll gut you like a fish.
Don't you walk away from me. You're as good as dead.
You've got a lot of nerve showing yourself in this town again. What do you have to say for yourself? Sorry's not good enough. Not while my Gleda's still out there alone and afraid. You kidnapped her and sold her to that giant. You're damn right it does. I'll never breed another prize-winning goat like Gleda. And don't you think of coming back to Rorikstead until you get her back from that giant. You didn't seem to need either to sell Gleda to the giant in the first place. I think you'll figure it out. You really don't remember stealing a goat and selling her to a giant? Are you thick? Go get her! At least she's bound to follow you back. You smell just like the fermented feed she likes. You mentioned something like that when you were running off with my goat. Tell you what, you bring back my goat, and maybe I'll give a damn about your staff. All right then. Name's Ennis. You talked to Reldith yet? She's like a mother to me. You hear from the city? I visit Whiterun from time to time, mostly to make deals. Reldith is the hardest working farmer in Rorikstead. I'm the one with the head of business. Need something?
Gleda! And not a scratch on her! Happy day!
I still can't figure out why you stole her. You left a note explaining it, but half of it was gibberish and the rest had mead spilled on it. Only bit I could make out was repaying Isolde in Whiterun, and even that's mostly scribbles. Guess you could try there.
You're taking us somewhere warm, I trust. are taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
Once I've made enough money trading with the Khajiit caravans, I'm going to buy the Bannered Mare from Hulda. Before my Ma and Da passed, I told them that one day, I'd become the best trader in Skyrim. I met one of the caravan leaders, Madron. He said he'd help me get started if I could bring him a mammoth's tusk. Easier said than done. You'd do that? If you find one, I could teach you a thing or two about trading. Help you get a fair bargain in the future? It's not about the money, really. I wouldn't have given you the wedding ring on credit if you weren't so obviously in love. But if there isn't going to be a wedding, the least you can do is give the ring back. That was one of my best pieces. You went right out to give it to your fiancé. Don't you even remember where you left her? And after you told me that sweet story of how you met in Witchmist Grove, I can see why she left you. Decided to go through with it then. I know you couldn't have forgotten about your fiancé. You spoke of her so glowingly. I don't know much about Morvenskar, but it sounded like a lovely place for the ceremony. Congratulations.
This here's a toll road, see? You're gonna have to hand over, say, 200 gold if you want to use our road. Huh! Tough talk for someone who's about to have their guts spilled. You picked a bad time to get lost, friend.
Hey! Careful!
A new hand touches the beacon. Listen, hear me and obey. A foul darkness has seeped into my temple. A darkness that you will destroy. Return my beacon to Mount Kilcreath. And I will make you the instrument of my cleansing light.
I've got your back.
That's a bit.
feeling there's trouble ahead.
Never should have come here.
You're here. I was beginning to think you might not make it. I thought you might not remember your first trip here. You had a big night. I think you've definitely earned the staff. Oh, the Hagraven feather and so on. You can throw all those out. You see, I really just needed something to encourage you to go out into the world and spread merriment. And you did just that. I haven't been so entertained in at least 100 years. Just a prank? Just a prank? The Daedric Lord of Debauchery does not deal in mere pranks. This may have begun as a minor amusement, but it wasn't long before I realized you'd make a more interesting bearer of my not-quite-holy staff. My pleasure. But I think it's time for you to go. No fun keeping you locked up in here with the staff.
Come on in. Just stoke the fire. Take a seat and get the cold out.